Right, well, chaps, let's start. Obviously, I've got the CEO Billy Wood here and the Supremo Chris Agutter. Where should we start, gents? Obviously, we've got the current league situation. We've also got talk of some serious contract negotiations. Where do you want to start, Billy?
Top if
Billy.
You want, Chris, we'll start right from the top. Like, we've got some news for you. This is an exclusive. You've got an exclusive.
Yeah, go on, mate.
So, negotiations have been done. We've come to an agreement, and Chris Agutter will be the Hastings United manager for two more seasons. So, the contract to 22-23.
Oh, that's brilliant. And I think what we need is a better. Come on.
I like this song, Chris.
It was, I think it was inevitable, really, based on the fact that as a club, with the ambition that we have, both as a club, and individual ambition as well, to take Hastings or to operate at the highest level possible. I know Chris has the ambition to, he doesn't want to be a step four manager for any longer, really.
No.
We've got to get out of it. And I think with our combined ambition, we want to be at the best level we can possibly be at. And we believe Hastings can be at that level. But I think my job as chief exec is to make sure all the tools are in place, whether I'm here for 1 week, 10 days, 6 months, 6 years, or 60 years, like to make sure that all the components are in place for this football club to grow and continually grow with or without me. And Chris is a massive part of that. And I see the next couple of years being vital for us as individuals and as a club in doing something this club should have done years and years ago.
Yeah.
And we were on the cusp of it. We were really on the cusp of it. It was taken away from us. But yeah, I think that, and Chris, you can go further into it, but I think the challenge is even more exciting now than it was probably a year or two ago.
Did you get his car, Chris?
Sorry?
Did you get his car?
Well.
Go, didn't you? You didn't have the keys off him?
I'm happy with my Ford Fiesta.
Oh, okay.
So no, I just delighted to get some concrete plan moving forwards. Delighted that I've been given the opportunity to keep moving forwards with the club. Credit to Bill, credit to all the board directors. You know, Darren, Peter, and Co. They're so supportive. So. You know, in terms of an environment that you want to work in, I couldn't ask for anything better. It's the only thing that sort of let us down or lets the situation down really is completely out of our hands in terms of the league that we're at. You know, we've done our part of the bargain in terms of winning games and putting points on the board and being better than everyone else. So, but, you know, we can't control that. And I just think the next chapter is an exciting one. Obviously, Billy alluded to it there. This team has been very successful. And I think there will be a little bit of evolution to the team now. I think for it to be freshened up again and obviously with the likes of Ben Ward moving on higher, there's an opportunity for players to fill the void left by him. Obviously, players are getting older now as well. So, you know, how much longer they've got, we're not sure. So I just think the opportunity to potentially build a different version of this team or a new team at Hastings and the challenge to be better than what this team has been, which is fantastic, is exciting. It's really exciting.
Yeah, great.
I mean, I know that, you know, everyone is really happy that you're staying, Chris, and Billy, you've done a great job since you've been in there. You know, everything has been moving forward. Everything has been positive. It's just this bloody virus has just tripped everyone up, hasn't it? And
I think.
Oh, I'm sorry, Billy.
On that, Chris. Just sorry to interrupt. I think on that, it's the components across the club that's making it successful. So it's the fact that we're not all going to agree on everything at this football club, right? There's times that me and Chris don't agree. There's times that I won't agree with Pat. There's times that I don't agree with Darren and Peter, right? That's just a fact. And there'd be other times where other people don't agree in the club. But we've all got one common goal, and egos are put aside. We all want success and we want to achieve that. And we're not blinded by the fact that someone else's opinion or spin on something might be better than your own opinion. So I don't profess that I've got every answer for this football club. And there's times that I've been proven wrong. Okay. I've been proven wrong, but it's understanding, having that belief in your team and your team having belief in you, that you can be wrong in the bubble, because as a bubble, you'll put it right and make things better. So that's why I think Hastings has been successful, because all I've done coming in, I feel, is looked at what's gone on the pitch, which is under Chris's jurisdiction, look at what's going on in the academy from the 16-19 program, and then what we can do to enhance below that from 16 down, and just enhanced it. That's all I've done, right? And looking at that, I've gone, right, okay, what is key going forward? It's paramount that Chris is the manager of this football club to take us forward. It's paramount that the staff stay, because Chris will always talk about how great his staff, his backroom staff is, but I get to see that firsthand too. And they're unbelievable people, especially when you go like Brownie, Pete Dane, Ben Cornelius, James McCrossan. They've taken Chris's philosophies on board, probably moulded them a little bit, and it's become something even more mega. And it's very, very exciting to watch. And then on the board as well, and the volunteers, they're the people that really help us make decisions, because they live and breathe it. So you have to take their feelings in consideration when you're trying to create something. If we just wanted to tick boxes and carry on and just play football in Hastings and rah, 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 fine. But that's not what we're trying to do. We're trying to create something that all of us can look back on, whether you're in it as a 20, 30, 40-year supporter, a new supporter to the football club, like obviously Adam is, the guy who's now doing our website, or a manager that's been here for 5 years, or a chief executive who's been here for 18 months, right? It's, for me, it's not how long you've been there or how long you're going to be here, but it's all of us can look back in 10 years' time, and don't matter how long we've been at this football club or supported it, we can say that we helped to create a culture that hopefully will outlive us all at this club.
Yeah, I mean, it's like a philosophy, isn't it? I mean, even when I was chatting with that Ben yesterday, who's obviously gone to Burnley, he said, well, when he gets spare time, he's going to come down to watch us play because we play great football. And obviously, he admires Aggie and that. But that, the key is that we play good football that's really exciting to watch.
Yeah, definitely.
And it's just a great selling point for anyone.
Yeah, no, I think so. I think so. And that's all credit to what's going on the pitch. Like, that's, for me, that's something I can't have an influence in. And it's something that I have to trust the people that do. And I have full trust in it. Full trust. And it's so refreshing to be in an environment that no one feels that everyone's trying to get slipped up on something. It's not a slippery environment. It's like, if I say something, it's direct. Or if Chris says something, it's direct. If Dane says something, it's direct. Members of this football, it's not a, well, plant this seed to make something happen, or plant this to make, there's none of that. And that's quite refreshing, because I know a lot of clubs that aren't like that, that there's a lot of people that are trying to fuck each other over, excuse my French, and just to better themselves. But I genuinely believe that if we carry on down this path, the reputation everyone garners at Hastings United might professionally spiral them on to other things, or they'd be on the journey to Hastings, to the National League. And that's what's exciting at the moment.
Absolutely. Anything to add to that, Chris?
No, it's just I think Billy hits a nail on the head. It's obviously, get announced about me staying on, but that also means obviously Brownie, Pete, all the people that work so hard behind the scenes. I think also, like, massive credit to the players as well, because if the players didn't produce on the pitch, didn't deliver, then I don't think I would personally be in a position to be offered a new contract at the club. So I just think it's, yes, it's about my name in terms of being announced, but in terms of like the bigger picture, it's just, I'm just one cog in a machine, and everyone contributes, to be fair, and the supporters are included in that. You know, I've banged on about it so many times, is it's so easy to attract players to the club now compared to what it was when I first came here. Obviously, the track record and the reputation of what we do helps, but the fact that now we're getting, assuming there's no restrictions, we'll be getting 600-700 minimum compared to the 125 that we had in our first sort of few weeks in charge. So I just think the supporters play such a huge part as well, and everyone sort of everyone contributes a certain amount, and that leads to success, and we just hope we can continue that.
Well, talking about the continuing success, I know you've all kind of been involved with this new plan, this project, you know, that's been sent over for the FA to look at, you know, the PPG. I mean, what is the latest with that?
I can quickly give you an update on that. I've just submitted our survey answers to the FA. We're fully backing the Project Non-League concept of promotion without relegation to help restructure the FA survey. We've put our application in, our survey answers in for the FA survey, how to finish the season. There's loads of different options on that. We as a club are supporting the Project Non-League concept, that the FA pyramid can be restructured to how they want it to be via promotions. So if they just do promotions based on points per game over the last two seasons, they can restructure the leagues without relegation, so no club will suffer. But the clubs that have actually kind of been ambitious, put their money where their mouth is at times, or actually just want to compete, they're not going to get, once again, castrated for the lack of ambition by other clubs. Like, with all due respect, I think Hastings United have proven in the last two seasons that we are not a step forward club. Fact, it's two league losses in two seasons. It's a fact. The win ratio, the clean sheets, the team that we put together over the last 2 years, well, Chris and his team have put together over the last 2 years, we'll play our part. We've put together over the last 2 years. I think we've proven that we're winners, and I think we could compete at a higher level. And my frustration isn't coronavirus. It's really not. I understand, and you know, the death toll's going up and up and up. And I think the vaccine coming in, the lack of the cases are going down. The cases in Hastings are dramatically going down, as I keep seeing daily by Wayne Southby's posts. Adds to that, COVID's not my problem. My problem is the rigidness of the FA system that I find really hard to deal with, in the sense that, for example, I feel that it's a lot of people clinging on to their jobs and are rigid without trying to put their head above the parapet and make something exciting happen. You know, the FA and also the Trident Leagues have got to look at it and go, cool, another year of this. Oh, well, what we'll do is we'll just restart in August and everything will be fine. Well, that's not guaranteed, right? So why not actually give people something to look forward to, give our fans, and also the fans in the Southeast, the South Central and the North divisions, give them something exciting to look at, you know, clubs that they might not have been to before and be able to play. It's like Groundhog Day. Yeah. Change it. Let us go up. Let Worthing go up. Let Jersey Balls go up. Let these teams that have actually gone out there and obliterated their leagues or sat top again, let them be rewarded. Let us have different away days for our supporters to go to. Let the Step 4 leagues have different away days, extra away days. Like, no, when you, everyone looks forward to it, looking forward to potential, you know, clubs moving over from South Central to South East. And, oh, we're going to be playing this team this season. doesn't mean because you've not been promoted that you can't have that excitement. That excitement can still live. And the teams that haven't, the teams that just sit there and trickle along, blaming budgets or bad management, managerial decisions or whatever, who are sitting bottom of the leagues, who want null and void because, oh, we've got to protect our position, right? Mm. Okay, fine. Protect your position. Stay in the league. But don't hamstring us and other clubs that deserve to push on, because all they're doing is stagnating. It's hard. Like, with all due respect, the club, will, if we don't push on at some point, we'll struggle to...
Yeah.
Chris might sign Chris to a new two-year contract, but we might struggle to keep Chris Agutter at the football club. We might struggle to keep certain players at the football club. Something might come up for me. You know, I have to look at on a professional basis. I have to look at my own career and where I want to go. And don't get me wrong, I'm fully committed to delivering this plan. But the longer we stagnate, who's to say something might change?
Yeah, change punishing ambition.
Absolutely. So I just look at this.
Just on that as well. Like if I'm one of the other teams in our league, I want to see the back of Hastings. 100%. I want to see the back of Hastings.
Mm.
If I'm talking about self-preservation, I want Hastings to go out, because we're not going away. If we're at the same level again next year, we'll be where we are again. You know, we'll make sure of it. Mm. You know, we're not going anywhere. So if I was thinking of myself in terms of as a club, I'd be going, right, let's get Hastings out. I felt it when Cray Wanderers went out of the division, because when they got promoted, obviously disappointing because we were in the race with them. But as soon as they were gone, it sort of felt, well, that's one hell of a rival, because obviously with Tony and Joe and everyone at the club, they're very well run. They weren't going anywhere. Mm. So I think from other clubs' perspective, why would you want Hastings in your level again? And I just think, I don't know. I see an announcement that Phoenix put out, and I thought it was really refreshing. Like, yeah. Phoenix back in the no to null and void, and actually going at sporting integrity. Let's reward success. Let's reward. I mean, we've lost two games in 2 years. It's mental,
mad, isn't it?
it's mad, and you just think. Actually, if I when Cray Wanderers won the league, I was the first person to text Tony Russell to say well done, because they deserve to win the league. They deserve to go up. And I just think if it was Cray Valley top of the pile, I would be saying the same thing.
Mm.
No, they deserve to get promoted. One, from a selfish perspective, because Cray Valley aren't going anywhere, and you know, they're always going to be competing at the top. But also, because it's the right thing to do.
Yeah,
no, I agree. Totally agree. But do I have any hope? Well, I think the FA and also the leagues have proven to be quite stubborn in their approach. And the Ishman League and, well, the Trident League's coming out and saying that they back null and void kind of tells you where they want it to go, right? So we'll see. We'll see what happens. I think the obstacles are put in the place of where points per game should exist at a certain percentage point of the season, whether it's 50-odd, 60-odd or 70-odd. There's those sort of questions that are in it. But for me, will we kick a ball till August, like competitive football again? Probably not. I don't believe we will.
Mm.
But for the men's side, for definite. But at the same time, like Chris says, let's reward sport and success. Let's actually do it. Let's do it and not be scared of it. But we'll see. We'll see. To be continued, I guess.
Yeah. Right, gentlemen. A quick thing. Can Chris you give a little message to John Wills? Obviously, Aggie is not out. Is there anything you want to say to John Wills?
Well, actually, written into my contract, it does say that as soon as my contract's extended, it actually means John Wills is banned from the club.
Yes. Hang on. Where's that?
He has to watch through the bars.
Yes. Do it, Wills. He's banned, mate.
No, and also, nah, I think it would be more painful for John as if I invited him onto the coaching staff. We'd have to work with him at the time. So.
Oh, okay. Well, chaps, what we got here? Yeah. So, I mean, we kind of talked about that. You got any summer plans yet? I mean, I know you're obviously going to lose a few people, as you know, I'm sure a few people have got some things lined up that you now may not want to speak to.
Talking about this window quickly.
Oh,
so talking about things. So, I've never experienced a transfer window where Hastings is. I doubt Hastings have ever been as active in a transfer window as we are at the moment. I doubt it. Nothing's done yet, but we've been talking to a lot of pro clubs. Now, we're not a club here for the picking, okay? So we're not a club that's going to stand around and get picked off by professional football clubs because we're producing players. It's not going to happen. Mm. We're always going to find the right deal for the player, for us, the player, and the selling club. We're going to think like that. We're going to think of the most fairest deal for all players that we're talking about. We're not going to sit there and just roll over to give a player an opportunity. It's not what we're doing. We create the opportunity by giving them the platform. Yeah. So by giving them the platform, we will negotiate fair but hard with any club. And I think some League Two clubs have felt that in the last week, let's just say, that Hastings United isn't a soft touch. Yeah. But saying that, we want to see players progress, and there is a balance between having progression and showing that for the academy lads and any young player that's dropping out of a professional football club academy in Sussex and Kent should be looking at Hastings United as an opportunity to rehabilitate their career, because we have proven and will continue to prove in this transfer window that Hastings United creates opportunities. So it's been, my phone has not stopped ringing. I feel like I'm at a Premier League club. The amount my phone's rung and the amount of different chairmen, secretaries and whatever I've been speaking to in league football. And also our players as well, reassuring them that we're trying to do what's best for them. Mm-hmm. And they get it. There's going to be a player or two that don't get it, or hires a dodgy agent or a big mouth who tries to bully little old Hastings, but we just won't have it. And it, you know, hopefully there'll be some news to announce soon.
Okay.
That'd be positive. Again, another positive story for the club, and shows that we're a club that's in the game. We're very much in the game, and that will continue. Oh, but you can talk about summer, Chris. That's your restriction.
Well, obviously, there's going to be no names there, but it just shows you that you're doing a good job. If people are coming in, they're seeing the things that are being produced on the pitch. And, maybe I'm just talking for myself. I'm sure I'm talking for most fans that, you know, for that, the standard of football that you're putting out there is well above what we're at now. And that's being noticed. And good luck to everyone that moves on. Because hopefully that people will see, as you say, the youngsters and that will see, well, look, come to Hastings, because players go places from here. Yeah, unfortunately, we've been tied down because of the COVID, that we would have progressed, but, you know, still it's going to happen. So have we got anyone? Are you looking at anyone, Chris? Are you bringing any new names in, or?
Yeah, well, Billy knows about it. It's part of our sort of planning behind the scenes. We've got a massive database of players. So, you know, we've got nearly 1,000 players on the database that we sort of try and keep track of, and try and see who the best performers are across non-league. That's not just obviously with a view to now, but it's if we get promoted, and so ensuring that when you do go up to the next level, you're aware of what's out there. So, we're always looking, but I think. If anything, the last sort of years taught us is that the lads that we produce, that the academy produces, you know, the local players, they are worth their weight in gold if given the opportunity. So Ben Ward is a great example. Was with the academy under Adam Hurley, I think under 13, 14. Was released by Brighton, come to us. Moved away from us, come back to us, now signed at a Premier League club. He's a great example because he's worked extremely hard, he's extremely coachable. And so you look at that sort of that lesson, if you like, and go, actually, there's plenty more to come. So I've said to the academy players, I spoke to a few of them last night, I just said that what you do in this break could define the sort of career you have, not just at Hastings, but potentially beyond. I know in the previous lockdown, Ben Ward outworked everyone. and it sort of paid dividends. And Ben at the time was just an under 18 that we'd taken with a view to playing potentially 23s football, who could support the first team squad as and when needed. And obviously he had his opportunity in pre-season and took it. So long story short is I think there's more Ben Wards there.
Yeah.
Definitely. There's more Tom Chalmers. There's more David Widaris. There's more Adam Lovitz. It's just a case of me and the staff having the thought process to go, actually, because you know what it's like. Supporters love, they love a big name coming into the club. So when Raheem Sterling Parker came into the club, he's obviously very well known. It was like, wow, you know, big, big player. And I understand and appreciate everyone loves a big signing. But I also think now there is more of an attachment with the team to the supporters because they're local lads, a majority of them.
Yeah, absolutely.
So like Jake Elliott is Eastbourne, Ryan Worrell Eastbourne, Louis come through the club. Adam Lovett was Eastbourne, David Bexhill, Nori is based in locally. So what I mean is these local players have an affinity with the club. They have an affinity with the support, which I think works vice versa. And ultimately, they're bloody good players.
Yeah.
So I think, as I said, that the last year has really taught us that we look within, you know, we give the opportunities within, and that we won't go too far wrong with that approach.
Yeah, great.
Oh, great stuff. Okay, I mean, just one more thing about the Tilekiln. Any news on the Tilekiln at all, Billy?
So I was meant to have a call with the council, a bunch of councillors yesterday, which they've moved because they've had a sit down and talk about the project and have some positive feedback for us. So it's a good thing. So I'm now waiting for that call to be rearranged rather than a couple of the councillors with the whole kind of board of councillors, which would be quite interesting. Obviously, I'm just a small cog in that. Darren Peter and former chairman David Nesselin has been a massive part of that. But yeah, it for me, my key on that is how it's going to affect our community. Like, you can hear all the hullabaloo about, oh, we're going into a certain area of the town and whatnot, but it's Hastings, right? Hastings and St Leonard's is one combined area that we as a club support that area. We've supported Surviving the Streets, a Hollington-based charity, a hell of a lot. There's more work. Lots of charities are reaching out to me and community projects are reaching out to me about stuff that we can do. And for me, to the councillors, it's simple. This project allows us as a club to have a larger impact in our community because we could put more resources into our community. We could do more projects for our community. And we have the facilities for our community. So all this rubbish and talk about how it's going to benefit Hastings and it's Hastings. Great. It will benefit the football club. Of course it will.
Mm.
The football club's needed this for about 50, 60 years. So the benefit of the football club is obvious. Part of the benefit to the local community is even bigger. It's bigger than me. Like, yeah, I love Hastings and as a town and will always shout about it. But so are the rest of our board and our management team and our players and that local affinity. So it's not just how I deliver the community, it's how we deliver to the community. And I'm looking at right now, I've been doing a lot of work with Egg2 for a local charity. And I've been fleshing out an idea that I want to launch at some point. That would be quite exciting. A bit of more one-to-one sort of community work that we can do. But I can't really say much about that yet because I've not got it finalised and I don't want to jump the gun. But Tilekiln for me is all about delivering something exciting for Hastings as a town that needs it regardless. Regardless, yeah, people want to walk their dogs and I respect that. People want to respect the wildlife. I respect that too. But let's be frank, the plan that we put in place, we thought about all those things. All those things are thought about. It's not like we've ignored that. And what we want to do is give a deprived town an exciting facility to use.
Yeah, and it's a hub of bringing people together. Like all of us at Hastings, when we come along, like, you know, there'll be a ton of things we all disagree on. But yeah, when you come together, it brings everyone together. It's a focus point of the town.
But Chris, it's not just for us, right? We offered, regardless, we offered Hollington an opportunity to come in on this project. Anyone can say we didn't. It's not true. We've got it in email form that we did. And the local council have that. On top of that, we've offered it to all the other clubs that use Tilekiln, right? That's the most important thing. Clubs use Tilekiln right now. And I care the fact that those clubs don't lose their facilities, and they understand that they won't. And we've made it clear to those clubs. And those clubs are excited about the Tilekiln Park project. And for them, brilliant. They get to play on a 3G pitch. They're not going to have any more waterlogged games called off. Mm. They're going to play on a smooth surface rather than an unkept council pitch. And they're going to have lovely change rooms to get change into. And a lovely bar that'll be run by Sam Smith around the next door. So, you know, what can you complain at?
Absolutely.
Yeah, but it's exciting. There's loads of little bits and bobs, but I could sit and talk about it all day, but I can't because I've actually got a call waiting for me right now. So,
okay.
Love you and leave you, Chris.
Oh, I am. Yeah. Oh, and take care. Right. Hey, Chris, quickly. Go on. Yep. You can go, Billy.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
Yeah, take care. Yeah. I'm going to be talking with Jake in a minute. Jake Elliott, yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, on the pitch, mate. He glides on there. You know when he's in form and he's fit.
Doesn't realise how good he is.
Mm.
That's my biggest challenge has always been to convince Jake just how good he is. It's amazing. A lot of the lads, they're not used to, do you know what, you're a very good player. They're not used to
they
that.
They can't deal with that.
No, it's almost like, well, what do you mean? Well, I mean, you're a very good footballer. Mm. And I think that goes a long, long way. And as I said, with more confidence and more experience, we had to work really hard to keep Jake in the summer.
Oh, really?
No, I mean, really hard. I mean, even now, I hope he doesn't mind because he's back in Bristol, I think, with his family. I think he's training with Chippenham at the minute. So he could easily play a higher level. But, you know, when he agreed to stay this season, he said, I'm in no rush. I feel like I'm going to improve working with you. I love what I do.
Mm.
I love the club. You know, he's a really, really good lad. Nice. Really switched on lad.
Yeah. Oh, okay. All right, Chris. Well, yeah. Thanks for your time. And I mean, I'm going to cut off, you know, I'm going to cut all this, the stuff out. So don't worry about any other bits. But
no, you're all right. I don't mind. I'm always, I always make sure I don't say anything that I wouldn't want any other. To be fair,
yeah.
I don't know whether you get the vibe, but I just say what I think all the time. And
it's good. It's very good. It's a very good thing. You need to, it's good to, where everyone knows where they're coming from, because unfortunately, there's many that don't.
No, I know. You
find somebody who does.
That's the biggest challenge for me, is in terms of when you're dealing with people, especially in football, when you're dealing with people, because so many things get said, and you think, well, I'm a big believer in picking up the phone and talking to people.
Yeah.
Because when people text, they tend to grow another 3 foot, and they can almost take things out of context. So I'm a big believer in talking to people, and it's amazing that when you actually have a conversation with people, it's completely different. But
exactly, you can get places when people text in, Facebook, all this thing, they're all giving it the big un, or that you can completely misconstrue what they're saying.
Yeah.
They can't put their arguments across. But if you're actually talking to someone, seeing that reaction, easy.
But it's like with the Tilekiln project. Let's put everyone, put all their egos aside.
Mm.
Does this town need a football facility as a community? Does it need it? Irrelevant. If Hollington are building it, if Westfield are building it, if Hastings are building it, if whoever's building it, does the town need it? 100%.
Yeah.
Like we've got no training facilities. We train at the Furs on a waterlogged pitch and on a mugger next to the pilot field, or indoors at the gym, which we're no longer allowed to do. So we've got no training facilities. So we've to preserve the pitch, we have, like last season, we went months without training on the pitch.
Madness.
So It desperately needs a facility. Are Hollington going to benefit from that? Yes, they can. Westfield, yes, they can. Every local club, yes, they will. Do we need it? So I look at it and go, so my son's in the academy. Mm. He trains in Alexandra Park because there's no other training facilities. It's for his development, they need to have a better training facility. But that's what I mean. And the thing is as well, people can talk about their own personal goals and their own personal agendas. Yes, people will gain out of it. But the most important beneficiary of this is the community. Hastings will have a facility which befits a great town and a huge population of young men, women, boys, girls that will benefit from that facility. So let's just put it to bed and let's get it done. That's what I think.
Well said, Chris. Well said. Oh, and Chris, look, you take care, fella, and have a good afternoon, all right?
Come on, Chris.
Yeah, mate, bye.